the U.S. Supreme Court upheld a Muslim travel ban, and the views Meghan McCain asked her co-hosts to consider the feelings of Trump supporters who support the ruling. The conservative co-host praised President Donald Trump's nomination of Neil Gorsuch as a brilliant political move after Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell disregarded the Constitution and held open a seat for nearly a year after Justice Antonin Scalia died. Even hardcore never-Trumpers wanted him to become president because they knew how important the Supreme Court ultimately would be, McCain said. A lot of people don't think it was stolen, conservatives obviously don't see it that way. McCain admitted she was not terribly familiar with the specifics in the ban, but she said Trump promised to ban travel and immigration from majority Muslim nations. Let's stop being surprised by President Trump's hardline immigration. It's what he ran on, it's what I believe he got elected on, along with the economy. While we may have vast disagreements on it, and it's highly polarizing, this is who this man is. Co-host Joy Beer corrected McCain. We're not surprised, Meghan, she said. We're just disappointed, over and over again. McCain asked her co-hosts to spare a thought for the nationwide minority of Trump voters who may not be able to fully enjoy getting what they wanted because some TV hosts did not share their enthusiasm. There's a lot of people not disappointed, McCain said. I think sometimes we need to reflect that on the table a little bit. Host Whoopi Goldberg disagreed. Not if we don't feel it, Goldberg said. McCain protested, saying 60 million people had voted for Trump but Goldberg questioned the numbers. I don't know who voted for Trump anymore, to be quite honest I'm just not sure, Goldberg said. I say that because I grapple with, did the Russians interfere? No, they didn't, yes, they're still interfering, no they're not. I'm confused on who the hell voted for who no matter who it would have been.